buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cooking and Castle's going to bring you a Cooking and Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cooking and Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you on NCTV. 450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings, apples, meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
We've washed and cleaned our potatoes and to begin our breakfast. And this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes frying up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for Cooking a Castle breakfast.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450. Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're going to mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plugged our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. We're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat. Resistance. Now, to give it a little Italian flair, we'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends, I'm Gary West.
And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle. Our potatoes sausage garnished with that Italian pepper just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go. Our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like. And there's our Italian version,
Come see us at lgkg.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast. They're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cook in a Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes. They're available anytime. On your time, cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cook in a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather.
Buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cook in a Castle is going to bring you a Cook in a Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cook in a Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you. Nancy.
...450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings. Apples. Meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
we've washed and cleaned our potatoes and to begin our breakfast. And this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes frying up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for cooking a casserole breakfast.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450. Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're going to mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plug our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. We're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat. Resistance. Now, to give it a little Italian flair, we'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends, I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle.
Our potatoes sausage garnished with that Italian pepper just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go. Our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
Don't love me for fun. me be the one. Love me for a reason. Let the reason be love.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast. They're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cooking the Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes. They're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cooking a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather, or rainbow together we'll find.
Buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cooking a Castle is going to bring you a Cooking a Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cooking a Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you. NCTV 45.
450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings. Apples. Meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
We've washed and cleaned our potatoes, and to begin our breakfast. And this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes fried up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for Cooking a Castle breakfast.
This program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station. Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're going to mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plug our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. As we're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat resistance. Now, give it a little Italian flair. We'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends, I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle. Our potatoes, sausage, garnished with that Italian pepper, just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go, our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
LGKG.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast. They're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cook in a Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes. They're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cook in a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather.
Buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cooking and Castle's going to bring you a Cooking and Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cooking and Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you on NCTV.
450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings, apples, meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
We've washed and cleaned our potatoes and to begin our breakfast. And this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes fried up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for Cooking a Castle breakfast.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450. Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're going to mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plugged our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. We're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat. Resistance. Now, give it a little Italian flair. We'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends. I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle. Our potatoes, sausage, garnished with that Italian pepper, just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go, our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
LGKG.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast. They're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cook in a Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes. They're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cook in a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather.
Buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cook in a Castle is going to bring you a Cook in a Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cook in a Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you. NCTV 45.
450. Newcastle's community television station.
Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings. Apples. Meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
we washed and cleaned our potatoes and to begin our breakfast. And this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes frying up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for cooking a casserole breakfast.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450. Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're going to mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plugged our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. We're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat. Resistance. Now, give it a little Italian flair. We'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends. I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle.
Our potatoes, sausage, garnished with that Italian pepper just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go. Our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
Don't love me for fun.
at lgkg.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast. They're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cooking the Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes. They're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cooking the Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather or a rainbow together we'll find.
Buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cooking the Castle is going to bring you a Cooking the Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cooking the Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you. NCTV.
450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings. Apples. Meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
We've washed and cleaned our potatoes, and to begin our breakfast. And this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes fried up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for Cooking the Castle breakfast.
This program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450. Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add 1/3 cup of oil. As we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add 1½ cups of water to our mix, and we're gonna mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plugged our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. As we're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat resistance. Now, give it a little Italian flair. We'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends. I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle. Our potatoes, sausage, garnished with that Italian pepper just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go, our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
LGKG.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast. They're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cook in a Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes. They're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cook in a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather.
buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cooking and Castle's going to bring you a Cooking and Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cooking and Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you on NCTV.
450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings, apples, meats. This place looks so familiar. Everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
We've washed and cleaned our potatoes, and to begin our breakfast, and this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes fried up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for Cooking a Castle breakfast.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450. Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're going to mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plugged our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. We're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat. Resistance. Now, to give it a little Italian flair, we'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends, I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle. Our potatoes, sausage, garnished with that Italian pepper just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go, our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
LGKG.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast, they're gonna go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cook in a Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes, they're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cook in a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather.
Buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cook in a Castle is going to bring you a Cook in a Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cook in a Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you. NCTV
450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings. Apples. Meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up, right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
we washed and cleaned our potatoes and to begin our breakfast. And this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes fried up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for cooking a casserole breakfast.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450. Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're going to mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plugged our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. We're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat. Resistance. Now, to give it a little Italian flair, we'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends, I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle.
Our potatoes sausage garnished with that Italian pepper just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go. Our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
Don't love me for fun. Love me for the reason. Let the reason be love.
At our law firm, we see you. Come see us at lgkg.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast, they're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cooking the Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes, they're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cooking a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather, or rainbow together we'll find.
Buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cooking a Castle is going to bring you a Cooking a Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cooking a Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you on NCTV.
450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings. Apples. Meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
We've washed and cleaned our potatoes, and to begin our breakfast, and this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes fried up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for Cooking a Castle breakfast.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450, Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're gonna mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plugged our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. As we're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat resistance. Now, to give it a little Italian flair, we'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends. I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle.
Our potatoes, sausage, garnished with that Italian pepper, just to give it the right look. And we're gonna plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go, our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
LGKG.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast. They're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cook in a Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes. They're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cook in a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.
Just like birds of a feather.
Yeah.
Hey, buongiorno. I'm glad to see you're up bright and early. And you know what? You need a good breakfast to start you on your way. That's why Cooking and Castle's going to bring you a Cooking and Castle breakfast. Yes, complete with Belgian waffles, fried potatoes. We're using Italian sausage because who wants that other stuff? And also garnished with a hot pepper. It's Cooking and Castle for breakfast. Coming right at you on NCTV.
450. Newcastle's community television station. Peppers. Mouth-watering fruit. Fine dressings, apples, meats. This place looks so familiar, everyone in Newcastle has to know about it. Yes, it reminds you of when you were growing up. Right in downtown Newcastle. Look at those fine lunch meats and ethnic foods. Yes, it's Joseph's.
We've washed and cleaned our potatoes and to begin our breakfast. And this is going to be scrumptious. We're doing some waffles. There's our potatoes fried up. Nothing better than some home fried potatoes in the morning for Cooking a Castle breakfast.
Program was provided through funding from Cedars Restaurant in Newcastle, Pennsylvania. A special thanks to Cedars, featuring Middle Eastern, Italian, and American cuisine. Today's programming is brought to you by NCTV 45 and NC Radio 450. Newcastle's community television station.
Now to our mix, we're going to add a third of a cup of oil as we make our Belgian waffles for this all-star breakfast. Now we also add our cup and a half of water to our mix, and we're going to mix this well and let it rest for a few minutes. Now we plugged our waffle maker in, and when the light turns green, we'll be ready to go. We're following completely with the instructions. And there we go. There's our first waffle. Now you could use this setting to make it as light and as dark as you want. Make sure that when you move it to a dish, you use a spatula that's approved and plastic for heat. Approved heat. Resistance. Now, to give it a little Italian flair, we'll garnish it with a nice hot pepper. Just on the side for looks, and feel free to indulge if you dare.
Did I get a kick out of you?
Hi, friends, I'm Gary West. And whether you find Augustine's Pizza at your local grocery store, well, the folks at Augustine's Pizza hope that their pizza is always your first choice for any and all occasions.
Today's programming furnished by a grant from Chalala and Carney Florist on Mill Street in Newcastle. Our potatoes sausage garnished with that Italian pepper just to give it the right look. And we're going to plate this up with our waffles to give you a real good look. And there you go. Our Belgian waffles, sausage, home fries, and a pat of butter in the middle. Now, feel free to add as much syrup or no syrup as you would like.
LGKG.com.
Hey, now wasn't that delicious? You know, serve that up for breakfast. They're going to go, oh my God, she must have stayed up all night. But you and I know, you watched Cooking the Castle right here on NCTV 45. And you got these recipes. They're available anytime on your time. Cooks, tips, it's all coming at you right here on NCTV 45 and Cooking a Castle. And remember, make those Belgian waffles. They'll love them for breakfast. And like I said, they're going to love it. Until next time, bon appetit.